Hello, this is Mark from My Keys to Music. Thanks for joining me on this video. Today we're talking about Lyle Mays, the keyboard player from the Pat Metheny Group. He has a very unique keyboard sound or synthesizer sound, and we're going to explore that here on our Nord Stage 3. Let's listen in. So a subscriber asked about a month ago if we could emulate this sound on the Nord Stage 3. And although I took an attempt at it with my own ears and just played around and experimented, and I got pretty close, but it wasn't until last week where Dr. Mix released a video talking about this specific sound. As luck would have it, there it is. Okay, so he unlocked the secret for me when I watched that video, and I recommend you watch that video. You can check it up here. I'll put a link to it. He talks a lot about how the sound came to be, and you know, Dr. Mix is a big fan of that. So it's a good video, and I highly recommend it. But regardless, I figured, well, let's take that same concept and bring it over to Nordland here on this channel, and we'll talk about it here on the Nord Stage 3, and I'll tell you the secret right now. If you want to get the sound downloaded directly to your keyboard, I have that available for students of the Master the Nord Stage 3 and Master the Nord Wave 2 courses, respectively. I also have it available for people who support me on Patreon at the Discovery level. Okay, let's take a look at the magic ingredients on how this sound works. You first start with a single oscillator, and that oscillator is a square wave. Pretty straightforward. In the case here on the Nord Stage 3, we're going to be adding a single unison option. So the unison number 1 is what we'll be adding to this oscillator, just to give it more of a stereo perspective and just a little bit of detune and widening of that sound on that single oscillator. But then we change the configuration of that same oscillator. We're still on panel A at this point. And we use the option called Fine Detune, where we actually tune the second oscillator just slightly below the first, just ever so slightly. It's almost hard to even hear that it's out of tune, but it is slightly out of tune. And then we use the modulation envelope of that configuration to adjust the pitch of the note when it's first played, 61 milliseconds to be exact. So we add a 61 millisecond attack and a 61 millisecond decay, and then the note settles down. So when you first push the note, it has a slight bend to it on every first time you push a key. So that's how this sound works. All right, let's go look at this on the Nord Stage 3. Here we are with the Stage 3. Currently, all of the magic happens on a single panel. Optionally, you could use panel B to also include a square, a classic square wave with a slight adjustment of pitch of 0.2 if you wanted to. This is what it sounds like with both panels. And that vibrato that you heard, I baked in, I baked it into panel A. Just, although it's not part of the sound originally that I can hear, it's something that would come in handy if you want to simply use this sound as a potential lead sound. So that's what it sounds like with both panels. I think it's a little thicker. But I also know that the panels are precious, and sometimes you want to use a lead sound on panel A and something else on panel B. So I've done this here so that it all works on panel A. This is what it sounds like just with panel A. You can hear that slight bend. It's very effective. All right, let's take a look at some of the details. As I mentioned earlier, we have the classic square wave, but with the fine detune option. Then the detune itself is ever so slight. You'll be using that detune here with this oscillator control, so let's take a look at how much detune that is. It's only a 0.03. In fact, you have to be very careful. You're just going to basically go to the very first notch that you see, 0.03. That's all it needs. Now listen to this if I were to make it more than that. So you get a lot of options here with that one knob. And you can hear, that's plain with no detune, and then the 0.03. Just enough to give it that body. Okay, so that's the basic sound. And then the modulation envelope, as I had mentioned, is, if I monitor this, it's a 61 millisecond attack and a 61 millisecond decay. So it gives us that quick jump when we first hit the note. And then the release time on that is, what do I have? A 3-millisecond release time. Now, another important aspect of this particular configuration here, we just talked about the modulation envelope, but a real key ingredient is how much of that envelope is going to be influenced. So if we take a look, that's an 8.3. So 8.3 is over here on the dial, somewhere around here. And listen to the difference when I go to zero. There's no pitch bend. As I move up, you hear more and more pitch bend. Listen to it with 10.0. You can really hear the pitch bend. So 8.3 is what I settled on, but you can adjust to taste. All right, and then let's look at the regular envelope here and make sure we've got that correct. That's a 19-millisecond attack, full sustain, and the release of 313 milliseconds. All right, pretty straightforward there. No velocity. I did mention that I have the vibrato affected with the aftertouch, so as I push, and then I push a little harder, I'll have some vibrato happening there. I do have a little bit of delay happening. Let's take a look at that. The tempo is 451 milliseconds. The feedback is a 2.4, and the dry wet settings is a 2.7 in the mix. No amp, but you can certainly feel free to do some EQ if you wanted to. And now for the reverb, we have a 5.0 amount along with stage 1 and the bright setting. So 5.0, stage 1 bright for the reverb. And then a couple important things here. We've got the LP12 setting, the keyboard track at 1/3, and the frequency here, that's a big one. It's 554 right now, but I think you can adjust this to taste. And before I do that, let me just go and tell you that the resonance is zero. So 554 is what I have it set at, but I think technically speaking, when you listen to that particular song, it's a little lower. It's down here. It's very subdued. As you bring this up, it really brightens the sound. So you can have some fun with this. You can start with the Lyle May sound if you're maybe perhaps accompanying harmony in a tune, but then it's time for the solo, so you can take the frequency and move it up, or you could attach the frequency with the wheel if you wanted to, which I don't have assigned now, but you could easily do that. So this particular knob has a big effect in this configuration with this square wave with a detune. There's a wide thing, a lot you can do with that. In fact, you could introduce an LFO too if you wanted to have it oscillate back and forth. But that's essentially it. That takes care of the sound. It's all on a single panel. I think it's pretty effective, and I was really happy to discover that it really is in that slight detune when you first hit the note that makes that sound.